So this episode is called Iguana Wars. What's a warrior being ready for war? Grip, a lot of calisthenics. With animals, especially wild animals, you gotta have firm grip, because if you lose something as you're grabbing it, that can cost you a ligament, it costs you some staples, some stitches. So I try to stay as fit as possible. So when I come across stuff in the wild that I have to kind of manhandle, I have a grip on stuff. So this is small workouts I do, these push-ups, pull-ups, dips, and then of course I touch the weights a little bit. Iguana Slayer 3000, you know what I'm saying? Okay, this is my work van. So, this is my place of work, of course. I got a boat. Now, out here in Florida, this is gold. This is how we save the iguanas. Yeah, trouble on the side, put me in a shop. Yeah, got the tennis chains on, and they real blingy. Keep the super car. Just like that. You grab a 10-foot boat, you put it in the back of your 10-foot space of your truck. One thing you know about Mike, aka Tarzan, I love all music besides country music. I like rock and roll. Of course, I love my hip hop and rap. I'm loving old school rap. Every couple videos, you'll see me jamming out to some dubstep, some Young Jeezy, some Skrillex, some Yo Gotti. You know, I be feeling different ways some days. You know, you never catch me listening to country music, ever, ever. Got a bag because I'm brown. On a more serious note, you know, I like to have fun. I like to enjoy life. I like to laugh, you know, play around, giggle. But a lot of things I take serious in my life are these animals, you know. It's really a war out here. And what I mean by a war is people actually kill these animals, one, for fun, because they're not from here. Two, people eat them. They're a nuisance. They're not from here. They're an invasive species. You're fighting poachers, you're fighting trappers, they're everywhere. One female iguana can lay 30 to 40 eggs, 50 eggs. That's one female. There's maybe 500,000 females out here. If you just say 50,000 female iguanas are out here and say only half of them lay eggs, and I would say half of those eggs are vile and fertile. One, no natural predators here. There's no jaguars here like there are in a natural territory. There's no animals that's really hunting these iguanas. Their numbers are flourishing. You see people swerve in the street and hit them. I've seen videos on YouTube, people have BB guns and they shoot them for fun, you know? And that stuff disturbs me as an animal lover, especially as a reptile lover. I take it upon myself to go out 3 or 4 times a week and I catch them. And I send them out and I give them new homes. I give them a second chance at life before they're even taken away and killed. Tonight, I have an order for 5 to 6 foot iguanas. So that's our goal for tonight. Let's get 3 of them. Stay tuned. This will be some fun. Certain trees iguanas feel more comfortable in, because one, they taste good, two, that gives them more leverage, more bigger branch space, and three, some trees provide the perfect coverage where if you're looking at it, you can't even see them because it camouflages so well. We stop right here and we're gonna grab another smaller one. Guys, look straight up. Like that. Now I'm grabbing him by his back legs right there because he can't scratch me or he can't bite me. It's called the perfect leverage. These animals, their main defense is gonna be their claws. He can't bite me. He can't fully turn around and get me. His body is stopping him. Perfect iguana. If you guys look closer, you can see these two big lumps. They're called hemipenes, and they have bigger pores right here. If he
females, it's gonna be really skinny right here. I'm not gonna have as much profound pores as you can see on this male right here. I mean, this guy is perfect. He's thriving out here in the wild. And someone will come along with a gun, BB gun, and they'll shoot this poor thing and he'll be dead. That's why we're saving him today. You think Odell Beckham got hands? Let's see your boy.
Now, with these iguanas, if you touch them from the back of their legs, they jump forward. You touch them on the right, you jump right. Touch them on the left, they jump right. Jump on the right, you jump left. You know what I mean.
And that, my friends, is how you catch an adult male iguana. That's what you call, my friends,
that's alpha male.
This is alpha male iguana. Hope you guys can see this. He's about 5 to 6 foot. He's incredibly strong.
He's trying to kill.
Incredibly strong. And this is where the gym and knowledge of catching all these critters plays a role. This is him, the alpha male, just for this tree. Now in this same pond, there's about 5 or 6 big adult males just like this. This guy's beautiful, man. Full tail, all his feet, all his toes. Look at that, man. This is a beautiful specimen.
Godzilla.
That's how you catch iguanas, Tarzan style.
Now, this delicacy
could feed a family one night. Iguana is about 20 to 30 pounds full of meat. I mean, they cut them up from the belly. They eat their legs just like chicken wings. Just like a chicken, they gut this animal and they eat it. Some people kill them for fun. They eat people's flowers. I catch them, I put them in a bag for a few hours, I post them online, and they go to new homes. They're pets, again, out of the wild, instead of being eaten on someone's dinner plate. I love it. Young male right there. That's what we do out here in South Florida. You run, but you can't hide. What you expect? Did you expect anything less than that? Now imagine this 2 to 3, 4 times a week. That's how we do it. We're saving iguanas.
Oh, shit! Oh, excuse my language.
He's not even full grown yet. Alright, buddy, relax. Alright, dude. Once you grab him a certain way for a certain amount of time, they kind of submit. You know, grab him the proper way, straighten him out. Beautiful specimen. He has a full tail. When you have a regenerated tail, it grows back, but it grows back a discoloration. Males get way bigger than females. This guy has all his toe. Look at those. Look at that toe right there, man. This is a beautiful toe. Man, talking about manicure and pedicure, boy. Climbing them trees is nothing to these guys. We got a couple of specimens, you know, in the boat. Got them in bags. Load them up into the van. On to the next spot. So I think we got like 5 or 6 or 7 iguanas out of here. And now we're gonna go to this bridge. All the iguanas sleep on, catching by hand, or walking instead of getting all wet in the boat and stuff. But that's how we do it, you know? By any means necessary, I'm out here saving these guys. Of course, it puts some bread in my pocket, but it gives them a second chance at life, which really matters to me. These iguanas, it's not a high price tag on them whatsoever, you know? So I do it for love of the game, love of the animals. And that's why we're here, that's what we do. So now we're pulling up to the second part of this bridge. Give me some more. Uh-huh. trees up here. Caught one, you know. After you catch 20, 40, 50 off this bridge, they kind of learn, don't sleep on the bridge no more. Last time my cousin slept on the bridge, he didn't come home. And then my uncle slept on the bridge and he didn't come home. And then my brother slept on the bridge and he didn't come home. You know what? I think I'm gonna keep my ass in these trees.
Having fun?
Hope you enjoy it.
This video is sponsored by Underground Reptiles. We have the finest in wild caught, captive bred, field collected and farm bred animals for your door, front door, whatever you want in the world that's legal that you can get as a pet, I can ship it right to you. We ship through Herb Services. Anything you want, cheapest shipping in the country for any animal overnight. You order me on Monday night, Tuesday morning you'll have it. And also, Conservation, Zoological Wildlife Foundation, DWF Miami, another place where I work. Great people. Make sure you follow all of us on social media. The link is right there. Boom. Follow that. Now let me remind you guys a helping thing we're doing for these iguanas. We're not hurting them. I know there's people out there like, oh, this guy's mean. He's snatching them out of the trees while they're sleeping. We're in Miami right now. We're in the United States of America. These guys are not from here. They get killed. They get harmed. They get eaten by many people. I know a lot of people are probably butthurt about this video. Your PETA people or your vegans or... We're on the same team. Same team, you know? I don't see a sense in killing these poor animals just because someone let them loose or they came in on a package on a cargo or something. This is a live animal with a soul, with a heartbeat, with a mind. We're in the jungle, we are one. We're united.